Welcome back, Jags. We're JAG TV, and we're here every week during Flex to give you some news you should know.
This week, we will take a look at the new buzzer system and how it works.
We will also visit downtown San Antonio to show you how you can spend your Friday night.
This is JAG TV.
Studio 126 on campus. This is JAG TV.
Underclassmen, don't forget Picture Day will be on September 11th through the 13th. You will be photographed during your English class, and your English teacher will be giving you more details.
Seniors, don't forget to remind your parents about the senior parent meeting on September the 12th at 7:30 in the auditorium.
PTSA Greenback Night will be on September 17th at 6 p.m. Be sure to invite your parents so they can come down to the campus and meet your teachers.
As the district looks to find new ways to increase school safety, the new perimeter fencing was completed the night before school started. Angie McCaslin show you how it works.
Where the district approved fencing around the schools is another layer of security to prevent unauthorized personnel from entering the campus.
There is one kind of by the bus dock area, and then there's the main one in the courtyard. We also are having two drive-through gates, one behind athletics, and one by the band pad, so people can't drive to the back of the campus as well.
The gates will be open and closed at certain times of the day to ensure maximum security.
So one of our morning custodians will open the gates in the morning. Around 6:30, 7 o'clock, he'll be out there opening them. At 9 o'clock, 5 minutes once first period starts, he'll lock those two gates. We reopen them right around 4:15, right before school's out. And then at 4:30, when the 4:30 bell rings, we lock the gates back up again.
Using the buzz-in system is a simple and efficient way to know who is entering the school.
In the back, they ring the bell, and I have them put their ID card right up to the camera so I can read it, and then I buzz them in.
There are a few things that students need to know.
The big thing is going to be making sure that people carry their IDs just so they can get in. If they don't have their IDs and we're not able to identify them, they will have to probably come all the way around the front of the building and get checked in through the front. So carrying the ID is really, really important. A Johnson ID, not just a driver's license. And other than that, it's just making sure we're here on time, because at 9 o'clock, those fences do get locked. So you're not too late for your first period class.
Students have varying opinions on the fencing and its effectiveness.
I kind of liked it before when there was no fence, but yeah, I'm indifferent about it.
I mean, it's not terrible. It does its job, so I guess it's okay.
For JAG TV, this has been Isabel Little.
Incidents of students caught vaping on campus continued to grow last year. Now, NEISD is taking more serious actions against students who are in possession of THC on campus. Preston and Eduardo have more.
From now on, students in possession of vapes with THC on campus will face felony charges and expulsion.
Well, the first step, if they're caught with a vape, the consequence is 3 days of in-school suspension for the first offense, and then offenses after that, it goes up.
The district has acquired new testing kits used to find traces of THC within vapes, and that process starts on campus.
So to get tested, there are test kits that we have on campus that we can do an initial test to see whether they test positive. And then once we get a confirmation that it's positive on our test kit, then they are sent to Austin to get tested more officially. And from there is where we process.
The entire testing process could take up to months, but everything is verified by the state.
So based on state law that started last year, if it comes back THC positive, that is a felony offense. And so for school-wise, a felony offense means expulsion from public schools. Typically that would be a 90-day expulsion, but depending on what level it is, it could be different.
And the state is still taking measures to make sure minors do not obtain a vape. This after a year that saw hundreds of incidents of vaping on NAISD campuses.
They just passed Senate Bill 21, which goes into effect September 1st. That is raising the age from 18 years old to 21 years old to even purchase those.
Random searches that occurred during school are in place to crack down on incidents of vaping, even as reports come in of students getting ill nationwide because of vaping.
It varies. We do minimum of 2 a month, but a lot of times there will be more. So there's a two two of our canines in the district that do random searches at all of our secondary schools, and we don't know when they're going to come until the day before they call us. So,
for JAG TV, I'm Eduardo Meza Rocabert.
While you might have lockdown drills in the classroom, campus administration wants everyone to know the campus alternative emergency routes. Josh Keating got a review from Assistant Principal Sean Reno.
While the campus will continue to practice safety drills, this year has certainly introduced new changes to promote a safer campus.
We'll probably see some changes on our campus in regards to how our adults and how our students access the building. One is the buzzing system in the front. I know that, you know, some of our students have probably already gone through that, especially our students that leave campus and come back for PAL, student council, pieces like that that will leave our campus. Making some changes here to make our campus safer.
Administration wants to encourage communication with students to give and get vital information. The administration also wants to make sure that students have situational awareness should there be an emergency on campus.
So obviously in the cafeteria, in this setting right here, we got a number of places that we could use for a lockdown situation if we had to remain in the cafeteria. One of the spots is our ISS room. This first wooden door, it's a large room with no windows that can be utilized in a lockdown situation or a situation where we had to take cover for weather. Another exit point through the cafeteria would be through the back side of the cafeteria, where we had to leave the cafeteria because the front of the cafeteria doors may be a dangerous situation, or maybe there was a threat, a weather situation, something out the front of our cafeteria, we could utilize the back door exit. If we had to leave the cafeteria, we could use the back door right here. We don't use this exit during the school day, but again, in an emergency situation, this is our back exit. It could lead us down towards the ROTC building, again to the athletic fields, eventually even to Roan Forest if we needed to leave the campus. There are a number of exits through the kitchen that we could utilize to leave campus if we needed to. The first exit right here is directly through this door. This door would lead you again to the parking lot right here on the side and allow you to utilize the exit off campus into Roan Forest eventually. So we can head through the lines that we talked about, the serving lines, have the entryway into the cafeteria, kitchen, and this is another exit point to be able to leave. Again, an emergency situation only, you could utilize these doors here to get you outside. It'll look very similar, obviously, to the back of the cafeteria, getting us to Roan Forest. And so our next exit coming out of the kitchen area.
From JAG TV, this has been Josh Keating.
Nick Cavazos is back with some more news for you from beyond our campus.
In case you haven't been paying attention, here's what's happening in the Alamo City. The state of Texas rolled out new laws raising the smoking age to 21 and upping consequences for online chatting. It Chapter 2 hit theaters this weekend, grossing $91 million in its U.S. debut. Apple held a conference yesterday, September 10th, unveiling new products in its main lines. The San Antonio Botanical Gardens is hosting sustainability walks to keep the park clean. That's all for this week, Jags. See you next time.
Despite the heat, parents and fans turned out before the first week of school to meet the Jags. Now, here are some highlights.
Thank you.
Now we send it to Nick and Ethan for what's going on in JAG Sports.
Volleyball played New Braunfels this week. While they didn't bring back a win, they did make New Braunfels work.
This Friday, the Jags will play Reagan at 5, so make sure to come out and watch an amazing game.
Tennis took on Madison Mavericks and ended up winning the match 10-2. For more, we have an interview with senior Milan Fernandez.
I started playing tennis in elementary school. I picked up the racket because my dad played, so I just kind of got into it through that. Memorable moment, I would say my freshman year when I went to regionals for the first time. It was a school history. It was at Brennan before I transferred. And then last year I won the district championship in doubles. I would say it's developed my character, made me a team player, made me work hard and commit to something and grind every day for a greater goal.
And now it's time for some football.
This week varsity played San Marcos, and what a game it was.
The Jags started off the game strong, going into the second quarter with a 14-7 lead.
At the half, Jags had the lead at 21-7, but San Marcos wasn't ready for what's coming next.
Johnson came back into the half, scoring another 7 thanks to senior running back Justin Rodriguez.
Later on a long run by quarterback Ty Reasoner took it all the way home with the Jags up 35-14. But the Jags still had a lot left in them.
There was still time for Justin Rodriguez to work his magic, scoring a 53-yard touchdown run.
Running back junior Elvin Simpson shows San Marcos how big we can really get by hurdling a player and yet again giving the Jags more points to put them up, 48-14.
At the end of the fourth, the Jags took it home with a final score of 49-14, so it was definitely a great night to be a Jaguar.
That's all we've got this week, Jags. Make sure to check in next time for your edition of JAG Sports.
This summer, if you weren't watching Netflix or on your spam, chances are you were on TikTok. Layla and Rain were there too.
This time last year, TikTok was just a Musical.ly replacement. But this summer, it took off and became one of the biggest video sharing platforms.
I think it's more like, I think they're trying to be more like Vine than they did in Musical.ly. And like do dumb dances.
This year alone, TikTok gained 500 more million users, adding up to a whopping 1 billion users worldwide.
Oh, I feel like TikTok's more of like a funny meme thing. The Musical.ly was like...
With its simple video making tools, TikTok makes it easier for anyone to gain a large following fast. Definitely faster than apps like Instagram. The app itself gives you tons of music to choose from, along with funny filters and effects. All that's left to do is be creative.
I know the Peppa Pig meme, I know the H2O meme, and I know the E-boy dances that song.
And anyone, literally anyone, can enjoy TikTok. For JAG TV, this has been Rain Antunes.
If you head to Southtown on the first Friday of every month, you can discover some of San Antonio's burgeoning arts and entertainment scene. Here's Aldara and Katie with more.
Once a month, downtown San Antonio is the host to one of the city's most popular art and culture events, First Friday.
Like, I mean, it's like a mix of everything. I think it's like art, music, more art, food, people just trying to promote themselves, I guess, in all different platforms and seeing what they have to offer. It's always new every month.
Anchored by Blue Star Arts Complex, First Friday was established in 1994 and has become the largest art walk in San Antonio history.
Like, yeah, it's constantly changing. It changes every month. Like, there's some things that stay consistent, but for the most part, like, I really liked the big mural of, like, the city. That was cool.
From downtown San Antonio for JAG TV, this has been Aldara Velasquez.
Now here's something fun from our crew.
Hey dude, what's up?
Dude, I'm locked outside. Do you know where my ID is?
Did you know the Earth orbits the Sun?
Okay, look, I know where it is, but...
So you want me to walk all the way outside to bring you your ID that you know you're supposed to have?
Dude, I promise, I'll make it up to you as soon as I can.
You can make it up to me now.
What?
You know exactly what's coming.
No.
Yes.
Come on, man, this is urgent.
My work is urgent too, so I'm signing out.
Wait. Fine.
That's all for this week, Jags. For JAG TV, this has been Katie Peters
and Javier Juarez.
See you next time, Jags.